What's up, guys? I just found out. I was looking on my Steam account and saw that they have officially announced Kingdom Come Deliverance 2, and immediately got super excited, wanting to come watch what I thought was the trailer, but now that I've got it pulled up, it's a 14-minute game reveal. I don't know what game reveal means, but we're gonna watch it and let you guys know what I think. Just to give you a little bit of context on my experience with the first one, I tried to play through it three or four separate times and hated it. The first three, two or three, however many, I didn't play it. And then on the last attempt, really got into it, learned how to play, learned how to do the sword combat, and just really fell in love with the game, beat the entire main story, beat every single side quest that I could. And so I loved the first one after I've managed to get through it. But let's have a look at this. I'm excited to see what the second one's gonna look like. Graphically,
When it
instantly
seems you're
well,
out
this is a trailer,
of
obviously, so it's gonna look a lot better.
There's just one man who gives a fuck. A friend who'll never leave you stuck.
Very dark.
Now who can that friend be?
I think this is Henry. It looks like Henry.
Henry. Our hero Henry.
Dude.
It's been a while.
These are real.
Now we can
These are real people. Okay.
Kingdom Come Deliverance 2.
Gosh, I thought that was graphics. Or like in-game graphics. I was like, what? No, those are real. This is the game. Okay. Jeez. It looks better. Still not like mind blowing. That looks great. Oh my. Okay. Man, how long has it been since the first one came out? Like 10 years or so, maybe 8 years. It might have been 2016.
I always dreamt of leaving this place. Becoming more than a peasant.
You know the trouble with an adventurous life.
And we got a hair change.
Started.
Congratulations, Sir Knight. You finally
Gosh.
Become a man.
This one's like feeling darker, a lot darker than the first one. The first one's pretty darn dark.
Wake up. Pull yourself together, Henry.
I don't know, the graphics don't. The lighting is better. The lighting's very good. Ooh, I don't know what in the world that was.
We'll hand anything on a platter.
So maybe they've changed the combat.
To men like you and me.
It does look
a long way to
better.
Go, your work
still,
is done.
Still a little ghetto. Gosh, I'm so excited. So what is the
merciful God? Be kind and protect us so we don't blow our arses off. Amen.
Still kind of got that Monty Python thing going on just a little bit. That looks nuts. So is that the church from the first one? I thought we were going to have a new area.
Hello, wait. And welcome. My name's Tom McKay.
Oh, this is real. That's Luke why Dale, it looks so good.
We're here to present the first in-depth look at Kingdom Come Deliverance 2, an action RPG set in a realistic world of the late Middle Ages.
We're in Kuttenberg, a gorgeous city at the heart of Europe, but also at the heart of KCD 2. So let's take you into the world of the game with the help of Warhorse, the creators of this medieval saga.
It's almost exactly 10 years since I was doing a video like this, introducing our new game. It's almost exactly 6 years since this game called Kingdom Come Deliverance was finally released.
Oh, it's only
been
6 years.
It's a perfect opportunity to show you what we have been working on those 6 years, which is Kingdom Come Deliverance 2. And where else to do it than in this magnificent cathedral in this royal city of Gutenberg, where majority of this game takes place. Back then, 10 years ago, at the beginning, it was only 11 of us in a small office. Now it's 250 people working very hard for years to bring you the ultimate medieval RPG adventure.
So they multiplied their work step by 25
times? Kingdom Come Deliverance 2 follows the adventures of Henry, a young lad who barely survives the invasion of a raiding force on his village.
That's so good.
Henry embarks on a quest of revenge against those who butchered his family and burned his home to the ground.
The first one's
so
good.
As a trusted squire and friend to young Sir Hans, our hero Henry is sent on a simple mission, but things turn ugly very soon.
Kingdom Come Deliverance 2 is a continuation of Henry's previous adventures, but the story's written in such a way that it's perfect for newcomers to Henry's journey.
Real-life Henry looks old, bro.
A character that I think everybody can identify with, because he starts off as a kind of nobody and goes through life with all these immense challenges. And I feel like everybody can relate to that.
Hans is all the kind of fun times and all the kind of ebullience and joy that Henry has in himself, but it takes a bit of accessing, and I think Hans really helps him to do that.
Whew. You were right about our stench.
Let's hope this water isn't too cold. You wouldn't want your pride and joy shrinking.
I'm more worried about it being too deep. Come on.
What we are making now is what it was supposed to be in the beginning, but we were not able to do it because we didn't have enough resources and experience and all that stuff. We've proven that the concept works, and now we can take it to another level, which we always wanted.
So this was their goal from the start.
Much bigger in scope. Original game, we had, I don't know, 3 hours of cutscenes. Now we have more than 5. Regarding the size of the world, it's 2 times bigger than it was. The story is long.
Real quick, I like, that's cool. I just, the world was so big and there's so much random traversal, and I'm kind of over this thing of like the world is even bigger than it was before. It's like, man, how far do I have to ride a stinking horse? But that's okay. Everyone's kind of still doing this thing where the world gets bigger, so you know.
Longer and much more epic. So previously it was about an issue of small nobility with bandits in their villages. Now it's about problems of kings.
It's like a war now.
Behemoth of a game in comparison to the first, in my opinion. I think it's got so much more energy and pace and adventure and action and fun and trial and tribulation and just everything that you could want from setting up the characters so beautifully in the first game and then throwing them out there and going, right, let's see what you're made of. This is going to be so much fun.
So the combat, I don't know, it looks similar. You have the 5 directions in the original game. It looks cleaner, but they don't have the arrows. I don't know if that's just a choice for the trailer or if those are just completely gone. But there's definitely like some new moves and stuff. I don't recall seeing like the shield uppercut. The spin that Henry's doing with the hammer is interesting. I don't know.
Henry is a young guy, so he's not really like so deeply entrenched in his already, you know, set character traits. So you can build your Henry in a different ways.
And that all means that it's actually on you.
Different ways.
And that all means that it's actually on you who you want to be. You can save the world, or you can help to punish it for its sins.
Oh, Okay, it does look, it really looks better.
The combat is also historically accurate, but we don't want to do that for the historical reasons or something. We want to do that for the immersion, and we want you to feel the sword in your hand. We want you to feel threatened by the enemies on the battlefield. We want you to fight for your life.
As far as missile weapons go, we added new type of weapon. We added crossbows. Also, some early firearms.
Okay, I thought I saw that earlier.
Kingdom Come.
I'm sure those won't be too
the
prevalent.
Good old school RPGs. It will always surprise you what you can and cannot do.
You know, you can be better in combat. You can be a sweet talking guy who talks his way out of problems. You can be a charming knight. You can be a thief. You know, a scoundrel. Anything you do will be recorded.
Oh my gosh!
People will remember it. They saw you do that. Our crime system.
Holy crap!
To that.
For example, when you are, I don't know, drunk and naked, people comment on that on the street, and now you can also reply. You can tell them, "Oh, I'm sorry." Or you can tell them, "Piss off, man."
If you do a lot of criminal stuff around the village, people will start being suspicious. They will greet you differently. So try to make these little things collapse into a greater mosaic where your actions are really reflected.
It will always surprise you what can be done in Kingdom Come.
That's awesome, man. So outside of the combat changes, it seems like they're doing a lot with the world. And the world was fantastic in the first one. The interactions that you could have with the different characters and how everything felt. Like, this world, to me, felt really alive. And I know that you've heard that said 1,000 times. But, like, comparatively to, like, something like Skyrim, like, this world really seemed like everyone had something that they were doing. So for them to go even further with that, that's awesome. I think the world's going to be super, super immersive.
We are moving to different places, so one map is taking place on the actual place that's called Bohemian Paradise. And it's really beautiful nature with quite unusual rocky formations all around. And then we are moving to totally different, rather urban countryside surrounding huge silver mining, very rich city. So there's this big city.
The Gutenberg is a huge step forward for us, and it was, I would say, biggest challenge in the game. Because from those small outskirts and small cities, you are really getting in the one of the richest cities in the medieval Europe.
And it's really big. It's even too big, in my opinion.
We are trying to go beyond
that
usual muddy, dirty medieval world, dark ages where everyone is dying from famine and war.
It was really like colorful.
Wonderful.
Like, it wasn't dark at all. Well, we have really beautiful environments. Like, players should go and explore all those like little woods and beautiful rocks and castles.
The thing that I love about the game most is just wandering around, because the nature is really beautiful. It's really serene, peaceful, and it's full of secrets.
So I don't remember anything like that in the first one, which I could have just missed.
The music is big part of the game. Jan Valta is the composer, as with the first game, because I think he's awesome, he's a genius.
The music was great, so I'm excited. Of course it's gonna sound great, right? The first one sounds great. They'll just kick it up a notch in this one, it seems like. Gosh. This imagery here is wild looking, dude. I don't know if they were actually... I think they were actually projecting this stuff. This game's gonna be sick, dude. I think, I feel, I hope. Hopefully it won't take me 4 tries to actually start playing it.
You can experience something you cannot experience anywhere else.
I think players will be really impressed by that.
My message to the fans would be, you are in for a ride.
Thank you for all your support. Please follow us on our journey to create something unique. Kingdom Come Deliverance 2 will be released by the end of this year.
Oh my gosh! By the end of this year, wow. And it's already on Steam, I guess, since you can wish list it. Wow. All right. Well, that looks sick, guys. And I am going to go wish list it right now. That is a really hard word for me to say for some reason. But like I said, the first one was so good. It takes some effort to really get through it. But at least it did for me. But once I did, man, I freaking loved it. And so I think this one's going to be just fantastic. The graphics look better. It's still not, like, mind-blowing to me, at least. It didn't seem like it. I was watching in 4K. I know that this video is probably not going to be in 4K. But you can go and watch the trailer. I'll have a link down in the description. The animations look a lot better. It looks like they're doing some new stuff. I'm excited to see what they do with the combat. A lot of people kind of hate the combat, and I know what they're talking about. When you don't have the Master Strike in the first game, the combat's miserable. And so you really have to get the Master Strike. Hopefully they've done some stuff to kind of break it up where you don't need that, and you're not just kind of looking for counters all the time. But we'll see. I don't know. I trust them. I trust Warhorse. After playing the first game, I think this one's going to be really great. So, but yeah, hope you guys enjoy. If you haven't, I would recommend really going and playing the first one. It's such a fantastic game, and I loved it a lot. So that's all I've got for you guys. I'll see you next time. Take care.